In this video, I'm going to show you a few ways to measure flatness. So flatness is the condition where you have two parallel planes in which the surface must lie. Those planes are unconstrained to anything. So that's why the flatness feature control frame doesn't have a datum reference. Now, I made a video about this before and I got a lot of grief for it. These are not all the different ways to measure flatness. There's lots of ways to do it. It's a tricky thing to measure, again, because it's unconstrained. There's no rule saying it has to be stuck to the table. What we're essentially doing, say this is our surface, we're trying to present it to our measuring instrument in such a way that we get the lowest reading between the high and the low points. If it's off, right, like this, we would get a high reading here, low reading here. So we want to move it so we get a reading here and a reading here, and they're closer together. The deal is you can move it to any place that's convenient to get all of your measurements, but you cannot move it in between measurements. So what I mean, you know, you have a part here, make your measurements, see the difference between the high and the low points. That's your flatness. You may move the part, take more points, and you might have a lower or a higher number. The difference between the highest point and the lowest point is your flatness value that you're going to record. It's the distance between those two parallel planes. Now, what we're going to measure is this part, but I want to start with a part I know is basically good, right? This is machined aluminum. If I wanted to verify the flatness, of this surface, the first thing I would do, and I've gotten grief for this in the past, in past videos, place it on the table. I would get my height or my indicator on my height gauge, zero my indicator, and see if I can get my desired flatness, whatever's in the feature control frame, if I can get under that with this method. Now, when I say I've gotten grief for this in the past, it's because the comments or people say, well, you're actually measuring parallelism. And that is true. This is how you would measure parallelism. But recall, flatness is a part of parallelism. If something is parallel to 10 thousandths, it's also flat to at least 10 thousandths. It can be more flat because with parallelism, we're stuck to the table. With flatness, if I get a reading here that I don't like, I could move the part in some way and measure it again, okay? So this part was flat within like a 2/1000 or something, right? Barely any needle movement at all. I wouldn't go any further than that. If I had a flatness of 5/1000, this part's good to go. Now, if you're looking for data, I suppose, right? You want to know what the exact flatness value is. It's going to be rather difficult because it's difficult to find that out. It's not an easy thing to ascertain, even with a coordinate measuring machine. I say that because there's basically infinite ways you could place the part to try to achieve the lowest reading between the high and the low point. All right. Now, let's measure this part. If I forgot, I'll put the drawing on the screen. We're looking for the flatness of datum A, 10/1000. So I'll zero my indicator, just like before. Nowhere close. The indicator dropped out. You can see a distance, you know, probably 30/1000 or something between the indicator and the part. The method that I did before will not work here, but I just tried this anyway because most parts come out flat and parallel, especially if they're machined. So what are we going to do? Well, let's try this first. I'm going to measure, I'm going to start at this end of the part, zero. I'm going to zero my height gauge. I'm going to come to this end of the part and see what the difference is. 47 thousandths. One technique that I'm going to try is I have a gauge block. 50 thousandths, again, not ideal. I'm going to hold the part up on that gauge block. And I'm going to see what I can get. So we're zeroed here. I'm just going to stay about a half inch inside of the part. Zero, we're going up to five, right back to zero, still below five, five, right? So we're between zero and five, except if I go anywhere near any of the edges, we drop off. So, is this part flat or not? Right. We're near the edge, we're dropping. I would say we're good to within about 10 thousandths. Right. Unless I get really close to the edge, we get all the way to 5. And I haven't seen a reading above 5 thousandths. I'm not getting a reading below. Ah, there we go, there's a reading below. Now, I would consider this when you're close to the edge, even though this is a 3D printed part. Say it was a machined part, that might be where your chamfer is. So I don't know. I don't have a good answer for you. Is it flat or not? You have this variation at the edges. That's something to talk to, you know, the inspection team or engineering, see if that's okay. Say the gauge block wasn't reasonable, right? I couldn't find one in the right size, or you just don't want to do it that way. Another technique, gauge blocks. I'm sorry, not gauge blocks, 1, 2, 3 blocks. I'm going to suspend the part in the air, right? So there, this part is exactly 2 inches above the table. I'm going to measure from the bottom. And I put some pressure on this. The downside to this is the part has holes in it, and they're going to be difficult to see from my position here. If we measure it like this, right, we're still getting about the same readings, way less than 5, right at the edge. It's a little trickier to do it this way, but it might be the only way, and I wanted to, you know, show that. There's more I could do here. I could move my test indicator so I can get a better reach under the part. So ideally, I could get almost all the way to the other side. But there's some problems with doing it this way. One, as you're kind of creating an artificial exclusion zone, so anywhere where the block is sitting, you're not measuring, let me move it. Anywhere it's sitting, you're not measuring the flatness. So that's a place where maybe it's not flat. And the other technique, I could measure the whole surface and then just vary how much I'm tilting the part. This would work better for a large part, right? If you have something big, right, it obviously work a little bit better than trying to reach something small. Another technique, I don't have the stuff for it here. You know, you'll see 3 machinist jacks. They're just little tiny jacks. And you can use it to level the part. It's kind of like the thing I just did with the gauge block. Again, this part is kind of too small for that. That'd be for a larger part. That is one technique to do it, but it's time consuming. So going back to the first thing I did, if it's a machined part, it's likely flat and parallel already. So I'll just plop it on the table and see if you can meet that flatness tolerance without, you know, going through any extra effort. Every other thing requires effort. I can't show it in this video, but a coordinate measuring machine isn't exactly the answer for this, because with this indicator, I can, you know, move around, check all the spots I'm interested in. With a coordinate measuring machine, some of them only take points, right? So you're kind of limited to how many points you're going to take. Some of them scan, right? So it drags the probe, but that takes time, right? It moves pretty slow, and you've got to tell it where to go. So what I just discovered, you know, with the edges, right, how they kind of fall off and are really not flat there. If I programmed a coordinate measuring machine, I might be nowhere near the edges. I might program a path that just does a grid a quarter inch away from the edges. I might not find that information out. Whereas if I'm doing on a plate, I get a better feel for, you know, where things are, what to look out for, right? It's easy, it's really easy for me to take this indicator and just move it, right? Just a little bit to see what's going on, than to program it into, a coordinate measuring machine, a CMM. So that's all I had for this. Just a quick talk about flatness. I'm sure there's other ways to do it. It's deceptively difficult. It's a deceptive tolerance in that, you know, it looks easy, like, well, it could be easier than flatness, but actually getting a value and getting, you know, the true flatness, I would say is rather difficult in some cases. So if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe, leave a comment down below.